Welcome back to Pulse Tech News. Somehow we are a week into October already, and the tension has become quite palpable as the PC hardware community awaits imminently promised product launches. Intel has left little to the imagination. An Arrow Lake S and Z890 motherboard announcement will almost certainly take place this week, but AMD has left us to sift through rumors and leaks about the 9800X3D that many have misinterpreted, in my humble opinion, and Nvidia seems more focused on letting the current RTX 40 series stock run dry than actually launching an RTX 5080 or 5090, almost as if they care more about making money than providing all of us with powerful gaming GPUs.
Yes!
Shameful. On the plus side though, NFTs are back. Those are nice fall temperatures if you remember. So let's pick some apples, make some cider, and enjoy this week's bountiful harvest of tech news.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by Thermaltake's The Tower 600 series cases, continuing their popular lineup of vertical body design solutions with more room than ever for high-end PC builds. With support for full-size ATX motherboards with hidden connectors, side radiator mounts with room for 360 and 420 millimeter AIOs, a dual-mode GPU mounting system, and vented side panels that easily pop off for access to cable management or the 13 fan mounts, the Tower 600 is both easy to build in and distinct in its design. There's an optional display stand and LCD panel too. For more on the Tower 600 series cases from Thermaltake, click the sponsor link in the video description. Last week's news of supposed RTX 5090 and 5080 specs, brought to us by Copite7Kimi, came hot on the heels of rumors that Nvidia had halted current-gen RTX 4090 production, likely both to assign that fab time to other more lucrative products and to reduce current for-sale 4090 stock leading up to the launch of their next-gen cards. Sad news for the landed gentry who can afford such things, we thought, but thankfully more sensible GPUs in the sub-$1,000 price range remain readily available. Or do they? Holiday shopping plans are a bit bleaker now, as it seems that the RTX 4080 Super, Nvidia's only card in recent memory to be both faster and less expensive than its predecessor, is rumored to be getting the axe from Nvidia too. This info originated on the Chinese board channels forums and was picked up by Harukaze5719, basically indicating that chip production already stopped as of September, and we should now expect to see actual retail inventory wane as board partners receive their final shipments in October. And while the rumor slash grain of salt warning applies as always with info that has supposedly trickled out of the supply chain, the similar RTX 4090 rumor from a couple weeks ago seems to be playing out in an accurate way. 3dcenter.org now reports that per PC Games hardware, major distributors are no longer allowing orders. The fastest graphics card on the market is currently being discontinued. European average pricing has already gone up by 100 euros in the past 2 weeks as a result. Whereas here in the US, for now at least, there are still some $1,800 RTX 4090s, and there are $1,000 4080 Supers as well, per PC Part Picker. There has been no update on the RTX 50 series launch either though, meaning we're looking at a few tough months for GPU prices if all this is true, and the 5080 and 5090 don't debut until January 2025 as speculated. And maybe some old school PC enthusiasts can chime in the comments to support or refute this, but this seems different to me. Next-gen CPU or GPU launches are often preceded by some level of stock control to prevent an awkward oversupply of last-gen parts, but usually that means an actual sale or something, not a three-month gap between old and new products leading to a shortage ripe for scalpers to take advantage of. We've also been experiencing an awkward oversupply of Ryzen 9800X3D rumors lately, which was supposed to launch in October. And then it wasn't, and now it is again. Or maybe early November. AMD still hasn't confirmed, but hot on the heels of the X870 motherboard launch at the beginning of this week, we have a picture of the box. From Moore's Law is Dead, and if you can see past the aggressive watermarking, we have what seems to be a slide from an AMD presentation, stating, "This legend is unbeatable," apparently referring to the 9800X3D, and ignoring that some words have established definitions, like legend, for example, which typically refers to a traditional story, or a noteworthy person or thing who has earned that status in the past, a peculiar superlative to apply to a product that hasn't even launched yet. There were also 9000 X3D benchmarks supposedly shared by Code Commando on Twitter Friday, dubiously posted in text format rather than screenshots, and identifying the CPUs by core count rather than their actual name. And it's Cinebench, a CPU test, not gaming where the X3D CPUs are supposed to have an advantage, and the multi-core scores are higher than their non-X3D counterparts, which is weird. Not saying it's impossible, but on the 7000 series, the X3D CPUs have lower core frequencies and therefore lower multi-core performance. So I'm just gonna say it. I think the latest round of 9800X3D launch rumors are wrong, and I don't think we're going to see it go up for sale until January 2025. Maybe AMD has something coming later this month or early November, but I do not think it's the 9800X3D. That's an opinion. So here, you can take my reporting with a grain of salt, but let's give it a month or two, and we'll see if I'm right. One thing we don't have to speculate on is the existing Ryzen 9000 series CPUs. They exist, but they didn't have the best launch, and AMD has apparently recognized that they need some help to redeem their lackluster first impression. Specifically, the 6-core Ryzen 5 9600X and 8-core Ryzen 7 9700X will now have a 105-watt TDP mode that won't void your warranty, resulting in about a 10% performance boost, albeit with a notable drop in efficiency. This mode will be available with AGESA code update 1.2.0.2, which also improves Ryzen 9 quad-core latency, so there's something for the whole family. And this also coincides with Windows 11 updates that optimize branch prediction for Zen 5 and Zen 4 processors, so it seems like AMD will finally have everything lined up and prepared for Intel's next-gen CPU launch. It's just too bad they didn't have all that stuff lined up and prepared for AMD's next-gen CPU launch back in August. Might have gone smoother. Speaking of Intel's next-gen CPUs, we seem to have a green light. All systems functional. We are go for launch, and rumors are further solidified to a most rock-hard degree that there will be an announcement this week on Thursday the 10th, with either a for-sale date or review embargo, or both, coming 2 weeks later on October 24th. Videocards.com seems slightly more confident than Tom's Hardware about this, and they add that, ooh, there's a top-secret pre-launch press briefing happening tomorrow on the 7th as well. And I'm not sure if I'm allowed to confirm this, but press briefings always sound like underwear ironing competitions to me. As one might expect leading up to a new platform launch, motherboard partners have jumped the gun just a bit and begun sharing images of their new Z890 chipset products, with Asus, for example, showing off an ROG Maximus Z890 Extreme, the ROG Hero, the all-white ROG Apex, and a handful of other boards from their Strix and Prime series. Another consideration for builders might be cooling, as the Arrow Lake S chiplet design seems to have shifted the CPU's hotspot to the north, meaning many CPU blocks designed for 12th, 13th, or 14th gen might not be optimal in terms of the liquid flow and microfin layout. This has been confirmed by Der Bauer, and we're probably going to see some blocks come out for AIOs and custom loops that are specifically made for Arrow Lake CPUs. But many cooler manufacturers will likely opt for a simpler solution, a low-cost offset bracket that moves the cooler into a more ideal position on the heat spreader. Just up a little bit. Speaking of simple solutions, Tech Briefs, which distills the tech news down to its essence for speedy consumption. There are a lot of folks in the southeast United States in need of speedy assistance at the moment due to Hurricane Helene making landfall last week and then sticking around to make an unwelcome tour of flooding and destruction. Before anything else, if you have the means to help with relief efforts, please check the NBC article linked in the description, which has multiple regions and agencies listed where you can donate or otherwise offer your support. Helping those who have lost loved ones, homes, and livelihoods is first priority, but the aftermath could have lasting impacts on the tech world as well, since the town of Spruce Pine, North Carolina was devastated by the storm. Spruce Pine is the best source in the world for the ultra-pure quartz that is used to build the crucibles that melt polysilicon, a vital material in semiconductor manufacturing. 70 to 90% of crucibles worldwide use Spruce Pine quartz, and both facilities in the town are shut down with no reopening date in sight. We had some more updates on the Nvidia app that is destined to replace the GeForce Experience. Nvidia intends to migrate all remaining GeForce Experience users to it before the end of the year, per Nvidia Jacob, and so they have been working to update the app with all the functionality that was previously experienced with the GeForce Experience. So along with ShadowPlay access, you can now toggle G-Sync on and off, there's multi-monitor support for RTX HDR, and the ever-important driver rollback feature that was missing from previous versions. You can also change the font style, size, and layout for the in-game stats overlay, and perhaps most welcome is something that's not there. The Nvidia app does not require a login by default. It is optional. For now. AMD pushed a new version of their Adrenalin software suite out on Tuesday, and the most noteworthy feature is Fluid Motion Frames 2, or AFMF2, the driver-level frame generation tool that is now out of beta. On the plus side, driver-level means it should work in just about any game to boost FPS and fluidity. On the minus side, not having per-game optimization might lead to inconsistency, and it's doubtful that AMD's 2.5x FPS gains claims are very accurate. Early tests seem to show about a 10-15% boost from just this feature, and just like Nvidia frame generation, there is a bit of added latency as well. Still, it's a bit of free performance for AMD users, so if you have a Radeon GPU, consider updating to Adrenalin 24.9.1 and giving AFMF2 a try. Finally, in closing, we offer our heartfelt congratulations to Noctua, who have birthed yet another new product. And I say birthed because their development cycle does seem quite labor-intensive. They've been working on the 140mm NF-A14X25G2 fan that launched Monday for nearly 10 years, though, and it's been 6 years and 5 months since the 120mm NF-A12X25 version launched back on May 2nd, 2018. And while it's said to be a true all-rounder that yields superb results in all types of usage, per Noctua, there's a lot more competition in this space than there used to be. You know, 10 years ago. If you dig the tan and brown though, a single fan is $40, or there's a $77 two-pack with one fan having a 25 RPM offset to prevent harmonic vibration. Now, they just need a clever marketing campaign to get fans drooling. Really lubricate those sales, you know. Use your head, Noctua. You'll get the job done. So there you have it, guys. Tech news for the week. And if you liked it, click that like button or leave me a comment down below. While you're down there, all the articles I talked about today are linked in the video's description if you're interested, and you can check out my store at paulshardware.net for high-quality merchandise, t-shirts, hoodies, beer sets, and more, as well as these awesome new mouse mats. Subscribing to my channel is always good call too. Memberships are now open as well. Thanks again, everyone, and we'll see you next week.